Hi, my name's Steve Backshall. I'm in the Shark Sanctuary of the Bahamas filming my CBBC show, Deadly Mission Shark, which will be coming to BBC iPlayer later this year. You've been sending in your questions via the CBBC website, and now I'm gonna get stuck in. This is Shark Chat. How long are a great white shark's teeth? Well, the biggest ones that I've ever seen have been about that sort of size. That's from a shark that would be 5 meters in length. They get to be over 6 meters, and I'm guessing then they'd be that sort of size. So massive, but still nothing compared to the shark of the biggest ever known to have lived, the Megalodon. And those teeth could be that big. Is it true that we have proof that Megalodon is still around today? I am so sorry to break this to you, but no, the Meg is gone at least 2 million years ago and possibly even longer than that. Why do sharks regrow their teeth? Amazing question. So sharks have teeth that are kind of on a conveyor belt. As the front ones break out, they're replaced by others that roll forward to take their place. And big shark species might get through 50,000 teeth in a lifetime. Effectively, those teeth are modified scales. They're generated constantly throughout their life, and it's just a really effective way of keeping them sharp and able to cut through their food. How strong is the maximum shark bite? The highest recorded bite force comes from the bull shark, but almost certainly a big great white is going to have a bigger bite force. They haven't been measured accurately. Their bite force is not as strong as the biggest crocodiles, for the simple reason that they have a flexible cartilage jaw. And when they bite down on something hard, their teeth break out. That's what they're designed to do. Whereas a crocodile has a thick, heavy, bony skull and strong, robust teeth that can withstand the immense power generated by their bite. Why are sharks carnivorous? Why do they eat meat? Well, the simple reason is that out in the sea, that's a pretty readily available source of protein. It's quite difficult to get protein from other sources unless you are a filter feeder who is noshing down plankton. There is, though, one species of shark, the bonnethead, that's been seen feeding on seagrass. That's right, a vegetarian shark. How fast can a shark swim? Well, the fastest shark species is the short fin mako, and it's believed that they can go at least 31 miles an hour, possibly even faster than that. Can sharks stop swimming? So many open water sharks, like white tips, great whites, and blue sharks, continually swim throughout their lives. But there are other species that will live on the bottom and not spend a huge amount of time swimming. They may have adaptations like spiracles, a little hole behind the eye that they can breathe through, or a buccal pump, which is something inside the mouth that keeps water churning over their gills. And that way, they can carry on breathing while just lying on the bottom. How do sharks breathe? So the main way that sharks breathe is using their gills. The gills are filled with tiny little blood vessels, which come close to the oxygen in the water as it passes over them. And that oxygen diffuses into the blood and allows them to breathe. Amazing questions, you all. Thank you so much for sending them in. They have really put me to the test.